are doing, is this your first MMA fight?
Yes.
And tell them where you're training.
Intensity MMA.
Intensity MMA. So you started training about 5 years ago, roughly. And I didn't realize this, but you're only 20 years old. So this is, you're really young to be starting your MMA career. Let's talk a little bit about how you got into MMA. You said your brother was in it first?
Yeah. He trained for like 3 years, I think. And he would like, I would sometimes, you know, like kind of wrestle with him, play fight with him. And
all of a sudden he has some moves that you didn't have the answer for. And then you wanted to learn it.
Yeah.
So he's training. He's you know, you guys are messing around. He's beating you in the little scrambles, the little wrestling, fighting at the house. And then you say, hey, I want to learn this stuff. So what was the first move he taught you?
I think it was Rear Naked Choke. And he also taught me like the arm bar and stuff.
But what did he tell you about that move?
Like, just like, you know, how to
but he do told it you,
correctly, push the head forward.
But he know? Told you don't do it on anyone. Yeah. He said, whatever you do,
I was young and
you can't do this.
You know, I would try it on someone at school.
Cut.
Yeah, I'm sorry, bro. It was good. I just can't hear you, bro.
Oh, yeah. So we'll have to speak up because the mic is up here. Yeah. Usually they mic is here. Yeah, I forgot to mention that, guys. Project.
I'm up all the way. So if you can just project a little bit more, because I'm all the way up and you're like barely bouncing on my level.
So pretend you're speaking to the guy like in the back, so to speak, voice wise. All right.
All right, ready?
Yep. What's up, guys? Jason Stewart, CEO, founder of Epic Fighting, here with Isaac Verdulo, who's training out of Intensity MMA. And tell us a little bit about how you started your MMA journey.
Well, when I was younger, my brother, he trained MMA himself, and he would teach me some moves, some jiu-jitsu moves while we would play fight, you know, wrestle and stuff. And I got into it, too, because of playing the UFC game on the Xbox.
So you're playing the UFC game.
At my cousin's house.
Your brother's beating you up, and then you're like, I wanna learn these moves.
Yeah.
And so he teaches you a move, and then he tells you, this is for self-defense only, never use it. Yeah. Right? He teaches you the rear naked choke, and then you go out there and you start using it on the kids.
Yeah.
So your coach said something pretty interesting about you. He said that you came in there wanting to train, and at the beginning, you were saying, like, you know, you want to do this, you want to be a fighter, but he says at first you were lazy. He said you come in there and you wouldn't want to push yourself too hard. And then he told you, if you want to fight, you need to bring up the intensity and you need to push yourself harder. And then he said it was a turnaround. And next thing you know, you're ready for a fight. And so tell us a little bit about that. Like, what motivated you to really kick it up? Like, was it just your dreams of being a fighter? Was it like you, something within you switched?
Yeah, I wanted to prove to myself, you know, that I could do it and that I could be better than, you know, most people. Try to, I think, you know, do it for respect in a way.
Respect, for sure.
Like, earn my respect in the sport.
And you want to go far with this. So you're thinking that this is, like, you're hoping this becomes a career for you.
Yes.
That's awesome. What you were a kid, you were having trouble staying in school and focusing. School was really tough for you. And so this is a good way for you to kind of like have a different route that you don't necessarily have to be good at school to be good at MMA. But it still takes the hard work and the discipline and stuff like that. Tell us about school. So you said you were diagnosed with like ADD, attention deficit disorder.
Yeah.
How was that challenging for you?
Well, like, I would actually, like, try my hardest, like, to focus, like, try to actually do the math and stuff, and, like, my brain just wouldn't be able to think, like, as hard as I wanted to, like, it just wouldn't, I want to, you know, make the bring up the answer to the question, and I just can't think of nothing, like, how to add, it was hard for me, you know, I'm not too dumb, but,
School is tough, and a lot of people went through that before ADD was a thing. You know, people in my generation and my parents' generation, like, that wasn't really a thing when we were kids. Like, just sit down and do it or don't. And they would just put you in a category like, okay, then you're not smart. It's not that we're not smart. We're just can't sit still for as long or can't focus. And then now I'm dealing with it with my son. He's got the, you know, ADHD and all this other issues where same thing, staying still is hard. But outside of school, you know, he does really well. It's just when he's can when they say stay in that spot, that's where he has trouble. And that, I'm guessing that you had the similar challenges.
Yeah, I couldn't sit in school. It was very boring.
So what is your favorite aspect of mixed martial arts?
Favorite aspect? I like the striking. I like striking and jujitsu.
Yep.
Yeah.
What, for the people that are coming to see you fight, how do you predict this fight's going to end? First of all, do you know who your opponent is? Have you done any research?
I've only seen a picture of him. That's
so you're not, you're only a picture. So there's just the face. So that answers the question. There's no study in this guy so far. Yeah. And some people like that. Some people like to, like, I'm training for a fighter and I'm going to go in there against a fighter. And some people pick apart every single aspect of their video. And then there's everything in between. So you're just thinking, I'm going to train, I'm going to be the best version of me, and I'm going to go in there, and whoever you put in front of me, I'm ready for it.
Yes, sir.
Okay. And so do you think, do you have a prediction, like what round it might end, how it might end?
I'm hoping for a first round, to be honest.
Knockout, submission?
Knockout.
Knockout? Punch or kick?
I'll give you a kick.
All right. All right, you heard it. First, it goes. First round knockout by kick, Isaac Verdugo, 20 years old, by the way, Montgomery High School, and, you know, there's a young guy. We don't know because we haven't seen any footage of this kid, so I'm excited to see what happens February 17th at Epic Fighting. You saw him here first. We'll see you guys at the show.